Hello everybody, my name is Patrick Oltenier, welcome back, and the last time with Alekhine's training, and once again I will show how to make chess plan, how to understand chess, and how to improve your chess. I have for you several examples, so I hope you will enjoy this video. For this example, you can see that Alekhine is black, and he's playing a good knight against bad bishop endgame. And this is a really important endgame to understand and to play really well. So, black is on the move, and what do you think, what's the winning plan for the black? Maybe stop this video for 2-3 minutes and you can try to find the right plan for black for you, and I hope you will enjoy this position and you will learn how to play these types of end games. So the best plan of course is to improve all your pieces. So it's not difficult, because if you are black you have only 2 pieces, and this piece I believe will be the great piece on this square, and this knight will be the great on c5 or f6, and I will tell you why. Because every time is important if you are going to attack opponent weaknesses. So if you have only 2 pieces, you have only chance twice to attack opponent weaknesses, and if you believe that the e4 pawn is the biggest white weakness, it's not so difficult to go to e5 with this piece, and you can attack this weakness with this piece. At the side, this knight should go to c5 and attack from c5, or even go to f6 and attack from f6. Your main plan is to win e4 pawn and lost g6 pawn, and if you will play this plan, at the end you will find another weakness, and it will be d5 and then b5, and at the end you will have more material and you are going to win this position. So now we can check this game. This game is from 1943, and Alekhine played really exactly this plan. So the first plan, he needs to go to e5. So just watch this game and we can understand all these moves. So well done, Alekhine made a first step of his plan, and he is going to attack this weak pawn. Of course, if white is doing anything, black will go to g5, g6, g2, g1, and one day white will have to take this pawn somewhere. But if he will do, we can take the pawn on e4. So even white will try to looks like he are fine, and he should defend e4 pawn. At the end, it's no way to defend this pawn, and you can see this is the best black's setup, because all his 2 pieces are attacking white's weakness, and this is the best plan for middle game. This is the best plan for end game. So we can play a few moves, and you can see that there is no difference in the position, and at the end we are playing g4. Of course, if white will take on g4, he's lost, so he has to do something. So he should go to g2, but now we are going to h5, and we improve really a lot our position, and I believe that this g4 pawn should be our big advantage. So for this reason, white moved to e2, but then he lost e4 pawn and he won g4 pawn. So as we spoke together, that black wished to exchange this weakness for this pawn, g pawn, because then you can see what's happened. Another weakness here, another weakness here, another weakness here. So that's really fun to play this end game, and I believe that it's not so difficult to win this position, because at the end you will take all, not all, but you will take everything, and in this position white resigned. So once again, so small summary, this position is won for black, because he has only 2 pieces, and he has the right to think that his 2 pieces will be much more stronger than white 2 pieces. What's in black's favor, that white has his owns structure on the light square, and his light square bishop is really unhappy with this structure. So we should have a really good minor piece, good pieces, and we should attack. This is really the most important information from this video. We have to attack our opponent weaknesses, and I hope you understand this game. And for this reason, we are moving for another example. So yes, we are in this example. Once again, you are black, you are Alekhine, and you can see that this endgame looks like black is with advantage, so black should play for win. I will ask you, what do you think, how to play this position? And once again, I believe that experience is the most important skill or information for us how to improve, because if we know how to play some type of positions, we should use it in our game. So it's important to see or to saw 100 positions, and with these informations we are able to make a right plan. So in this position, the right plan of course is to improve to d4, and then we should go h6, g5, f4, e3, and we should win this game. This position is won for black, and the main reason is the difference between activity of last two pieces. You can see, and I hope you will agree with me, that black has only two pieces, but these two pieces are much more than twice active and stronger than white pieces. And that's difficult. That's different. It's the best word. That's different, and it's good to have this feeling. So if you have better pieces, you are playing for win and you have advantage. This is a really way how to spot who is playing with advantage. And now there is no way and no question that black is in a right way to win this game. So, and everything is going under plan. So now, because we have, if we are black, the best army in this war, we'll play h6, g5, f4. And that's so simple. So you can see that you can play this position without thinking. And now it's important to stop and think one more time. Now is maybe more difficult position than I show you in the first before first move, and this position is important because you can see that this open edge file, it's important file. It's very important to not lose this open file, and if you are not careful, white should have a chance to go to h1, somewhere to h8, and then be active on every square he wish to find. So for this reason, it's good to think what's our opponent's plan, where our opponent has a chance to play, or where our opponent has to be active. And if we will see that this h file is his last chance, it's good to not allow to take him this last chance, but go there and be the first in open file. So for this reason, rook to c8 and rook to h8, and now f4, take, and rook to h2. Every time you can try to attack anything, you know, if you wish to have good pieces, strong pieces, that means your pieces is attacking pieces. So maybe in this time, in this position, this rook looks really well. It's not bad rook, but this rook on h2 will be much more stronger because this rook is attacking f2, and that's a different. Everybody believe that if you are attacking, your opponent has to defend, and that's a different. You are improving and your opponent is not improving his position. For this reason, black went to h2, and I love these games because in these games is everything. You can see that how to play this position, how to make chess plan, and at the end how to win winning game. So I believe that even this position should be interesting for you, and everybody should learn how to play better chess from Alexander Alekhin. This position is interesting and I believe it's important. So maybe watch this video twice and I believe that you are able to improve your chess. In this game is black on move, and this is another typical plan for black. What do you think in this position is the right plan? And I will give you a secret. If you are in this type of positions and you have pawn on e4, that means on f3 it's not a knight. That is a really typical plan, and this plan is to go into attack. Attack white king. This is a really standard and typical plan because you have pawn on e4 and you have or you are winning fight over f3 square. So now it's important to think how to make attack, how to make a plan, how to attack our opponents exactly in this wing and in this territory. And for this reason, it's good to know this this game, because even Karpov or Kasparov learn a lot from Alekhin. So if Alekhin used to be good teacher for them, I believe should be good teacher for us as well. So in this position, you can see that in this territory is one defender. So it's important to shoot last defender, and even this bishop is a good bishop. We have to take this knight because it makes a sense. It makes a reason why we are going to exchange this bishop for knight, because even we are going to exchange our good bishop, we are exchanging defender. And because our main plan is going for attack, we need to kill or shoot every defender which is going which is playing against our plan. So the first move is simple, and now it's not so difficult. This knight will be going one day here. This piece will be going to d7, f5, h5, and we'll try to checkmate on h2. And you can see how it's important to not have their defender. Of course, this rook has open space to go somewhere here, whenever. And maybe even this rook should go over a5, over the a6, or should go over d or e file on the right wing. So even this knight should go somewhere here one day. And it's important if you wish to attack, is important to attack with all pieces, not with one, not with two, but have a plan for all pieces. And now we should watch this game, and we can see that white is really in a big problem. And knight to e7, it's a good move, because at the first plan we are going to stop. We are going to take care about d5 pawn, and we are going to d5 one day, and now everything is going over our plan. So we are going to f5, we should go to g4, we should go to h5, and we should make checkmate to h2. So we are going to d5, and now we are playing b5. Why is b5 important move? Because if we are playing only our plan, it's maybe very strong plan, but our opponent maybe wish to go to c4 and e5, and I believe that we should have more difficulties to win this game with this knight on e5 than on a3. So for this reason, Alekhin played one more move here, and he played b4, b5, sorry, and he wished to stop this knight to go to e5. And every time, this is really the most important way how to improve your chess. You have to understand what are you playing, and you have to understand what's your opponent's plan, what's your opponent wish to play, and if you can, you should stop his plan immediately. And you know, it's good that play chess where your opponent will not have any chance to win against you. And move b5 is a beautiful move. You know, if you understand chess and if you understand ideas behind this move, you should say to yourself, yes, it's interesting move, it's good move, and well done, Alekhine. You played a really interesting chess because you don't want to see knight from a3 on e5, and after b5, we can see that the knight on a3 is a really bad knight. So with one simple move, with b pawn, we say to our opponent that we know what our opponent wished to play, and we are ready to stop him to play any active moves, and that's a really good signal to show him that we are a strong player and we are a really good player. Yes, of course. Now c6, of course, we don't want to lose material, and now we are going to f5, h6, we are going to take care about c pawn. Now it's time to attack, so we are going to g4, and you can see that the attack is rolling, and rook to e6, maybe we are going to f6, attack on f2, and even now we don't care about material because for white is too late to think that he will win this game because he has more material. White will lose because our attack is so strong. So now black took on f2 and black is lost. Check, and black won. I believe that this position is interesting position. It's interesting position because it's good to remember that with this e4 pawn, our main plan is usually attack. And if there is any defender, it's the best plan to shoot this defender and ship there all our pieces and play for attack. So this position is typical position, and I hope you will remember this position, and I'm sure that yes, and for this reason we are going to another game. This game is difficult, yes. When I saw this game, I thought that it's difficult, but it's nice. Looks like white is under problem because black is going to attack d5 pawn, and it's difficult to think that white should play for advantage or white should play for win in this game. But there is another secret. If we have advantage of two bishops, and we have if we are white, because black has only one, it's important to improve bishop which our opponent doesn't have. So if our opponent is playing only with light square bishops and he's not playing with dark square bishop, for us it's important to improve as much as possible our dark square bishop, and that's the plan in this game. So maybe it's good to know it. Then we wish to see move g6. If we will see move g6, you can see that this open file will be really weak. Now this open file is not so bad, but with move g6 it's really bad. And if we will have the right feeling that this open file dark squares are weak in our opponent's territory, we should play against dark square weaknesses, and there should be a lot of threat and very big difficulties for black. So now is question how to say our opponent to play g6. And I believe with the right question, you are able to find move knight to h4. Because yes, we are going to attack this pawn, and we wish to see g6. Maybe now you can ask why black should not take on d5, and it's a mistake because we will take, and now immediately you can see what's different if you have strong bishop. And we are playing maybe here, and this is a really strong, because if black is going here, he is losing piece, and if he is going here, black is losing game. So that's a different if you have feeling that you have two bishops and you need to play for maximum activity of the in this position dark square bishop. So for this reason, after knight h4, black went to d7. But you know, once again, Our plan is not to see only this piece on d7, but our plan is to see the pawn on g6, and this is really important. So next coming move, I believe you are able to find, and you are able to understand why white played bishop to h3. He is going to attack one more time on f5, and the main reason is to say black to play g6. And of course, after this move, black has to play g6, but now you can see that this should be the biggest black weakness, and this is the biggest chance for white to win this game. So another rule, I like the rules. If in our territory we can see some our opponent's army, and we know that in our territory is knight, the first and the most important plan is to shoot this knight, is to say this knight just go home, leave our territory. It's not any chance to leave this knight here, and for this reason move f3, it's making sense. At the first step you are taking care about every danger which is close to you, and to see knight in our territory, it's maybe dangerous. So f3, we are saying just bye bye to this knight, and we move to g5. You can see that this position is really difficult for black. Here is too many threats. For example, the first threat is to take on f5. Another threat we should take on f5. Maybe we should take on g6. And of course, another threat is to take on f6. And everything is coming from this beautiful strong bishop. And the really amazing chess plan where white wish to see move g6. He wish to see that black will be weak on dark squares. And you know, in a difficult position, it's not too hard to make a mistake. So maybe b4, e4, and you know, even this position is not so bad. It's difficult to play for black, and even in every hard position, our opponent should make a mistake. So there's some interesting variation, what of course Alekhine saw, but the game went till fast end by the move to h8, and you know, you can see that this bishop on b2 is a really strong bishop, and at the end threat g5 is the biggest threat, and that's the reason why black resigned. Once again, if you wish to improve your chess, it's good to remember that if we have two bishops, it's really important or strong to play to make our bishops really strong. That's my advice and my lesson from this beautiful game. And we are going for another example, black on move. What do you think black will play in this position? Maybe stop this video for 1 or 2 minutes, because you know, these examples are really nice examples, and with every new examples you are taking new experience, you are taking new skills, and I believe it's worth to spend 2 minutes to find the best way or best moves for black. So black has a really simple plan. It's important if in our games it's only one open file, it's important to take care about open file. It's really necessary to be only who is the boss of open file, and you know, if you will lose white over open file, maybe you will lose a game. But if you will win fire over open file, you should win a game. So the biggest plan or the most biggest challenge for you is to win fight over open file, and in meantime, if you have chance to decrease your opponent's activity, just do it. And that's why the first move is h4, and you can see that this knight has to go back. And that's mean Knight on g3 is not a superstar, but on e2 it's a bad piece. On h1 is a dead knight. So if we have chance to decrease our opponent's activity, just do it. And now we are playing knight to f5, f6, and it's time to go to over. It's time to go to open e-file. So one rook, making space for another rook. Another rook, making space for the typical Alekhine fight over open file. So he loved to see rook and queen at the last position. This is the strongest fight over open file, and he did. You know, now it's no doubt who is a lord of open file, and is black. And you know, for example, now is a beautiful move that black wish to go to e3. You know, that's amazing, and it's maybe hard to believe that black has chance to go to e3. And believe me, black will be there in two moves, and maybe white has no chance to stop him. So he's going to a5, and he's speaking, hey white, just stop me to go to e3. And if white will take on d5, white will be losing after this moves. Of course, this is a really bad, and you know, it's lost because there is so many threats. So white played b3, but black played knight to c4, and that should be shock for white, because it's really bad to take this knight. Maybe stop this video and try to improve your calculation and your feeling for danger or feeling for victory, because what's happened if white will take knight on c4 and white is lost? So check, and you know, it's game over for white. It was so fast to lose the game. It was so amazing and so surprise shock that in this position, this maneuver is so strong and so beautiful. So it's difficult to spot this maneuver. It's good to remember this maneuver, and I hope you are enjoying this video, because at the end, it's end of the story. If you have so big army in open e-file, you are chess grandmaster. Believe me, this is a really bad position for white to play, and there is no way how to save this game. Move by move, black is winning. Of course, if now black will take on c3, white will take on f1, then g2 and h3, and you know, that's really funny how Alekhine played these games. Again, it's bad to take this rook because black will do the same. And one more time, white should not take the rook because the same threat. So you know, it's like a game between big master and small children. Anyway, that's why I love these games. And you know, in these games is everything, and beautiful games, and Alekhine won. Everything started somewhere here, where you have to make the right plan. And your right plan is to understand that open e-file is the most important topic and plan in this position. So remember that if you will play a game when will be only one open file, your best plan is to go there and take it. That's the best plan, and this game is really old. It's coming from 1936, so 80-90 years old game, and still has the same information to us. It's good to know that with one open file, it's the best plan to go for this open file. And this position, it's won for white. It's important to know the best way how to win. So the best way is to go to I think just to stay here. Then this knight should go and f4, b4, a4, b5. Maybe now I told you some bad messages, so maybe you will not understand what I mean. That's why I will show the game. The first move is going to open a file. As I told you, open file is important in the middle game, is important in end game. And you can see that black has another open file, so it's important if you are losing one to win another one. Open files are a really important topic, and you know, if you have feeling that open files is the best files for your rook, well then you are improving. Now, white wish to play a3 and b4 because it's important that knight on a6 will be bad piece, and it's important to not let activated this knight. This knight maybe love to go to c5, maybe here, maybe here, maybe here. It's not important where, but we move a3, you are taking the first important square, and now you are playing f4, you are taking another important square, e5 and threat, and you know, now you are improving. So maybe it's a difficult game to understand how to play, but at least you should understand that move by move, white is taking important squares, and you can see that nothing big change for black, but change a lot because knight on a6 is a bad piece. Bishop is doing nothing, this rook is doing nothing, this rook is nice, but as I told you in the first diagram, it's important to attack something, but in this open file is nothing to attack for black. So yes, he is boss of open file, but that's everything. And maybe he wished to double, but after f5, you know, once again, there is the biggest difference between activity and not activity. And when black lost on h7, he is lost in this game. So what's happened? I think the last example, a beautiful one. So take care and take time and try to spot a winning moves for white. And I will give you advice. You have to attack opponent weaknesses. So start where your opponent has weaknesses and attack this weakness. And if you will do it, you will win this game and you will really improve your chess. So stop this video for 10 minutes. And try to attack your opponent weakness. It's beautiful. And if you did, the best way is to attack on a7. But you have to go with this rook to a5 to attack. And you have to go with knight to b5 to attack. And that's the nearly winning plan. Of course, you have to go somewhere here to not lose this c4 pawn. That's everything what you need to know about how to play endgames. Just to attack as much as possible, as strong as possible, our opponent weaknesses. And if you will attack, your opponent will be in defense and you will win lots of beautiful games. Now it's time to show this game. So, first plan is to take care about c4 pawn. Now is going to change this these two pieces, is going to rook to a5 and knight to b5. So, okay, we're going to take care. We are going to say goodbye this knight. We are going to b5. So first move, we are going to attack on a7 and we are on the right time to attack second time. And maybe you think there is not so big difference why to attack opponent weakness if our opponent has time to take defense, and that doesn't make sense to attack something where our opponent should be twice and should be okay. But if we are attacking, our opponent is defending, that means we have activity and we have more moves. And b4 is a really strong move because you can see even in this position, it's really bad problems for black and it's difficult to find the best way how to play. Maybe a6, okay, why not? But once again, we are attacking another weakness and this is a weakness. So, even here black is lost because he is losing his pawn, and of course maybe it will be exchange, but at the end this is the a very important advantage because we are 1, 2, 3, 4 moves from winning the game. So we have another plan, and of course we have another advantage to take more material. You can see how it's important to have strong pieces. If you are attacking something, maybe next moves, you will be attacking another weakness. So yes, you can see that there is so many plans, so many ways how to improve our positions. And once again, I believe this is the best way how to improve our chess. The best way is to watch the great chess players of chess history and learn from them. And you know, there is so many informations which we should learn, which we should improve. And I believe if you really wish to improve, you should watch games of Alekhine. He should be the one of the best chess players of all time, and I will show at the end all these games again. And now you will have feeling that you are understand in the next 5 seconds what to play. In the first diagram, once again, I will ask you what you think is the best plan for Black. And of course, it's not difficult if you know what to play. This position, of course, is so simple for Black to win this game, but you have to know the right plan, and I'm sure that you know it. Another plan, what to play here, and you can see that there is only one defender. So attack defender, exchange defender, shoot defender, and then because you have e4 pawn, there is a signal for good for attack. You should see that this is a really strong plan, and you know it's coming from Alekhine. So we should say thank you to Alekhine. We should say thank you for your great lessons and for your games, because we should learn how to make our bishops strong, how it's important to play for this bishop, and why this bishop need to have open file. And the same, another example, how it's important to fight over open e-file. And if we are able to win this fight over against open e-file, we are able to win the game. And this is really beautiful. I hope you enjoyed this game, and I hope you are improving chess player. So thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much that you saw this video. Thank you for your likes, dislikes, not too much, but if yes, of course, thank you. And if you will press follow our YouTube chess channel, we will have more energy to make more videos for you. So we are improving in videos, so I believe you are improving chess, and all together we will be a really big chess family. So thank you very much for watching, and that's everything. I hope I will see you next time, and next time I will make for you, of course, another interesting chess video. Once again, thank you a lot, and see you soon. Bye bye.